Now, here's a question for you. What's the one thing you can't live without? Food, shelter, money, a car? Perth film director Lincoln Fenner has travelled the world in search of the answer, from the bright lights of New York to the slums of Kenya, documenting his discoveries and wowing audiences with an award-winning film. Jasmine Homer has more.
We've become so immersed with ourselves.
A lot of people trapped in that mentality that, no, no, I have to have it. I knew I needed to ask questions that sometimes people didn't want to be asked.
In New York's famous Times Square, a big moment on the big screen for a documentary made by a Perth bloke.
I guess the film's really about why we have a craving for more in our materialistic society.
Scientist-turned-filmmaker Lincoln Fenner is Perth's answer to Michael Moore.
What happened was I saw this footage of these children opening these shoe boxes in Cambodia, and they're sitting on this mud floor, and there's a charity called Samaritan's Purse that did this thing called Operation Christmas Child. I found out that these were the only gifts these kids had ever got and probably were ever going to get.
In the face of the global financial crisis, what's the one thing we can't live without? Well, I wanted to know, so I set off around the world to find out.
I thought, what if I went to Cambodia and asked those kids, what if I went on the streets of Perth, what if I went on the streets of New York and asked that question? I thought, I bet you I'm going to get some pretty different responses.
It was a journey that took him from the slums of Kenya to the high streets of Los Angeles, with one burning question for everyone he met.
What's the one thing you can't live without?
Water.
Yeah? Without water.
I just can't stop buying shoes, though. But loads. You never know, you might need them one day.
A lot of documentaries love pointing the finger at the politicians or the celebrities or the rich people.
But we can all do something.
The opportunities are there.
What's different about more for me is that it actually looks at us.
What do you think the enjoyment factor is for people?
Knowing that 99.5% of the people in the world can't afford it.
Certainly one of the ones that stands out was we're in Los Angeles on Rodeo Drive, and one of the people I interviewed said, oh, a couple of $1,000 a night of gambling in Las Vegas.
Anything that will make you feel good and feel more confident about yourself.
The surprising and encouraging thing was that most people have good hearts and most people want to do things, but they're kind of trapped in the me mentality of, I have to get everything for me first before I can do something for someone else.
This morning, More For Me is in the Metro newspaper. That's the free paper picked up by everyone who rides the subway throughout New York City.
To a beautiful and talented director, Lincoln Fenner, please let's give him a hand.
4 years of filming and editing later, here's Lincoln at the New York City International Film Festival for a screening.
Pretty amazing to see that up there when we'd been there 4 years earlier shooting in the middle of Times Square. I certainly never thought that would happen, and it was pretty amazing.
And an award he wasn't expecting.
The Audience Award for Best Documentary will be awarded to your film. So.
It was a buzz. It was an honour. I had people coming up and wanting to be involved and wanting to get on board with the kind of mindset that the film talks about.
Perth's most dedicated philanthropist is another fan.
The Governor, Malcolm McCusker, really commended the film, congratulated myself and the cinematographer, Andrew Hooper.
And the doco, done from a home office in our northern suburbs, is now in high demand.
We're talking to a couple of distributors in Australia, a couple in the US and several in Europe that are all after the film.
Lincoln Fenner's already donated $11,000 profit from his new film to charity. Jasmine Homer reporting there.